Confucianism believes that the highest goal of human life is the development of the self in all its entirety. So, here is the story of Milo Alonzo, Rihanna Daz, and Christine Naje, three young ladies who share their experiences and progress from childhood to the present. Ever since they were a child, they have known that they live in a woman's body. These girls love to wear girly items, love to be extra with their clothes, and are curious about the accessories of their mom. During their childhood, playing with their friends would be a good time for them to show their good cooking skills with their cooking toys, play bahay-bahayan, and imitate the role of their mom based on how their mom acted.
It wasn't easy for them all to reach adolescence, especially in this new generation. They began to expose themselves to modern technology where the internet and digital web are now part of their daily lives, and people are free to express themselves. Being involved in the digital world gave them positive and negative effects on their lives. Some of them experience identity confusion, while the other one used her media accounts to showcase her passion. Experiencing these positive and negative effects of media led to other results that affect their physical self. Comparing their physical appearance, skills, and lifestyle made them insecure about their physical self. Because of these effects, it might affect how they interact with other people as well. The behaviorist Hilbert Ryle from Western philosophy believed that the self is defined by the behavior that is displayed to the outside world. Some of our actions might reflect what we do in our daily life and describe who we are. Part of their self-growth and training themselves is adapting to a new environment. 2019 was the year they transferred to the La Salle University Las Marinas as a senior high school students. They all choose to adjust to an unfamiliar community for their growth, change for the better, and meet new people. The three girls were hesitant if they could fit in with the students in the institution. They thought that material things like fancy cars, gadgets, and other costly material possessions are the basis of friendship and relationships. However, as soon as they met other peers, they realized how important it is to take care of personal belongings regardless of how valuable or inexpensive they are. The three girls belong to different strands and sections. Christine came from the business strand, while Milo and Ariana came from the humanities strand. Luckily, during their adjustment period, they met friends that made them happy and grateful that they had someone to make memories and bond with inside the campus. And it became their motivation to do better at school. They also joined an organization for other engagements where they could share their skills, enhance their talent, and meet many people who share the same passion. Because of that passion, they had a stronger relationship that made them closer. The relationships that they had built with their friends at DLSUD serve as a conduit to thrive and flourish as a person. Although they were doing better in school, it was a challenge for them to manage everything they did where it gave them stressor effects like sadness, frustration, disappointment, etc. But it doesn't stop there. All their hard work and efforts made them think that everything they do has its meaning, and they were able to cope by seeking support from other people and acknowledging that the changes they experienced were for the betterment of their life.
For the three of them, becoming part of the LaSallean community helped them develop different skills that made them grow into a competent individual, have confidence in their decisions, and empower themselves to live healthy lives. According to Ariana, being a LaSallean helped her in many ways, such as being politically aware, knowing nationhood, and what values to look for in a leader, which can help her strengthen her choice. Christine mentioned that being a LaSallean helped her strengthen her faith in God, which led her to serve other individuals, be more compassionate, and appreciate the creation of God. Roaming around the campus helped her admire, pay attention to nature more, and encourage everyone to take care of our environment. One lesson they learned is that the students in that institution may have different religion, but it should not be a hindrance for them to have unity, and it shows how the school values respect for each individual. They believe that applying the core values of faith, zeal for service, and communion in mission would help them be more confident and competent in every decision and action they made as a Filipino LaSallean. According to them, learning never stops, so with the guidance of the institution, stepping outside their comfort zone from the very start was the right decision for them to grow, learn, and share the wisdom with other people. living and continuing the mission of St. John Baptist de la Salle by strengthening their relationship with God and serving the community could help them be better LaSallian. Stepping out of their comfort zones could not just help them explore their social skills, but at the same time, it taught them to get to know themselves, those things that they are capable of doing. The philosopher Socrates mentioned that the unexamined life is not worth living. According to Cotton, having self-knowledge can be a way to happiness and satisfaction in life.
According to Cherry, 2021, Eric Erickson was interested in how social connections could affect the development of a person. The stories revealed how they grew as a result of their social interactions and how they pushed themselves out of their comfort zones. When these three girls started growing up, it wasn't easy for them. It's a world where they have to start unraveling on their own, find the meaning of their existence, and to make every moment count. From a newborn child who enjoyed thumb sucking, playing with a toy, and having a role, to a girl who enjoyed mimicking her mother, a teenager who experimented with many hobbies, and now, a young adult who is focused on their paths and preparing for their future job. It is a journey that is authentic to every single one of us, a meaningful life that teaches us to be compassionate, empathetic, and take accountability for all the decisions we will and ever make.